And hello everyone, and welcome back to Space Empire 5 for our Galactic Conquest. So, yeah, I said in the last episode this game's actually deeper than Paradox games, and it really is true. People, I'm sure, are complaining about that. Ship. We're going to design a ship. This is the ship designer. It's going to be a colony ship. Hang on. I think I just need to check something here. Interesting. Did I get that tech? Okay, yeah, I did. I for some reason didn't think I got light hull construction. Like above level 1. Which is fine. It's fine. Doesn't matter. So, you'll notice that there are things that must be done for the ship to be a valid ship. It must have a bridge, must have at least 50 crew members, or at least life support and crew quarters for 50 people. But I can, let's just say, skip around that with this, the Master Computer. Master Computer basically makes it an automated ship. Ooh, sorry, more Victoria Day fireworks. Which allow me... okay. 5, 8, 10, I think that's the max I can have, yeah. Ships of maximum movements. Perfect. That's really all I need to make a valid ship. It can now fly, and really, that's, I think, all I'm going to do. You know what? You know what, though? I'm going to give it a little bit of supply storage. Supply storage will give it an increased operational range and can fly other places faster. And we are now going to give it a name. That's Computerized Rock Colony. I'm not giving it any armor. By the way, I should probably explain this. Actually, you guys can read. Armor section, inner hull section, outer hull section. Figure it out. No, the armor does not go on the outer hull, it goes on the armor sections. Okay? Okay. Set design type. Colony rock. Okay, create. Done. Computerized rock colony. We're also going to create another ship. You can create bases, satellites, bases can't move, obviously. You can actually make star bases that can construct things. It's like build ships. And even other star bases. Inception. Anyway, we're going to again make another ship, but this one's going to be a frigate. Probably should have got better sensors, but oh well. Make do with what I have. Oh yeah, we're going to want a master computer on this one. Yep. Okay, we capped out at 12. Supply storage. No armor or anything. This is going to be a scout runner. Select design type. There's no scouts. Boarding ship carrier. Really? Pop transport, mines, vapor, troop transport. Yeah, there is seriously, no scout type. Well, whatever. It'll be left unclassed then. Computerized scout. Okay, create. Yep, alright. Okay, so. Now, we need to actually tell our planet to create one. We can go to the planet and go to the spaceyard. Here we can see the stats on the planet, how quickly it can construct things, how much facility space it has. Each building takes 1,000 facility space. Ships. We're going to make a computerized rock colony, then a research center to fill up the last facility space, and then a scout. Okay? Okay. That'll cover my production for the next couple turns. Yes, I'm sure I want to end my turn. Now, there are 16 players in this entire game. We've achieved tech level 2 in physics. And we've discovered lots of different technological areas. Whoa! Stupid fireworks. Made me jump almost. Okay, so 71% can go into temporal studies. That'll unlock temporal technology, which is very important. Now, let's see. Things I will most hellishly need are sensors. Sensors, sensors, and more sensors. Tech level 1 and temporal studies. Good. Back to research. Now, where's temporal technologies? Here we go. I'm going to take that out. 88. Okay, so 81%. I want temporal technology level 1. Because it starts unlocking better sense. Oh yeah, that's right. Temporal sensors are way better. Frig. Screw that. Temporal technology. We'll just be grabbing that. Because it's awesome. Okay. Well, I don't really need that. I'm going to give you the order to colonize there. Boom, 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 boom. And it just sits in orbit around there. Speaking of which, I can actually rename these things. So, we're going to make our homeworld Alexandria. Boom! And, yeah, I think we're good. For the love of freaking fireworks, man! If it wasn't so unbearably hot, I'd be able to, actually can't close my window. Anyway. New colony, component developed, facility developed, facility developed, yada yada yada. So I've got a bunch of new facilities. Now we have 2,500 tons of facility space, which are going to be important. Oh wait, I can actually add stuff. I am actually just going to add 20. Add item. That's going to take 15 turns, okay. Percent combat. I'm not really going to need that. I'm going to want a temporal vacation service, though. Entertaining the population to view past histories. Yeah. God damn those fireworks, man. I really do apologize. Anyway, temporal spaceyard facilities are just better spaceyard facilities. So, yeah, do I really? No. That'll be good. So this will be a gigantic research compound over here on the second planet. This thing is now working away. And in like 3 turns, we'll be ready for the next thing. Shoot, I didn't train my research. Oh well. It's not a bad thing to be investing in temporal. Temporal related stuff is good to invest in. Unless my research points available are going up as I am building more research facilities. What would I need to put it in otherwise? I mean, I'd be putting in sensors right now, so. Yeah. I guess. Because I have nothing to do until my scout's ready. Like I said, I'm going to want to be increasing my temporal tech because it gives me some good scanners. Warp. Alright. Ooh, pretty. Very pretty. And very explodey. Bang. Bang. Okay, really? Come on. Interesting. I'm actually so far away from the firework, I can see it explode before the sound reaches me. Not bad. Anyway, firework show. Stupid Victoria Day. Anyway. Let's warp to our adjacent system and see what's there. Will it be a nebula, a black hole, a star, a binary star system? Who knows? Let's find out. Two research centers, cool. Okay, so it's a star system. Let's start exploring. What? No, I didn't want to rename it, I wanted to move it. Okay. No planets yet. There are no system modifiers, nothing like nebulas that mean the system can't be scanned. Or anything like that. So yeah, this thing is building research compounds, which is great. It's very quickly going to become awesome. But it is going to be a bit of a resource sink. I'm going to need to get a mining colonies and stuff. There's an ice oxygen planet here. If I develop ice colonies, I could go there. And a fairly awesome asteroid belt. Cool. Stellar storm, nothing bigger. But yeah. Okay. So yeah, we've developed, what are you building right now? No, I meant you. You're not actually building anything. I am... What? No. I want to build a computerized rock colony. Yes, I wish to end my turn. I don't know how to demolish buildings, so I really want to get rid of the space yard facility there and build a temporal one. Like, I can build, like, flying ships that can build other ships, but the reality of it is the temporal space yard combined with my hardy industrialist. Like, some of the planets I'll be able to build will be able to just, like, kick out battlecruisers, like, a couple battlecruisers every turn. Yeah, temporal sensors level 3. Temporal sensors are very good. They come from my temporal technology tree, which is pretty great. Oh, we've got planets. Large ice oxygen. Tiny ice oxygen. Okay. This is good. Oof, a gas giant oxygen. I am liking our neighbor system. It'll be a while before I can colonize any of this, but that's okay. Methane atmosphere. That's alright. Very good, very good. Carry on. You're still not done that? Or, no. Yeah, you're still not done that anyway. I don't know why the population went down, but oh well. I think it's because I built that colony ship. Like I said, I'm not an expert in this game by any means. This game is incredibly deep and incredibly complex, and being an expert in it is nigh impossible. So I apologize if you're better than me at this game and are raging at the screen, but oh well, nothing I can do. Wow, there's just oxygen planets galore in the system. Oh no, I want M. Ice methane. Alright, carbon dioxide gas giant. I think that's about all the planets in the system. They tend not to occur too far out. Like, along the edge where the warp points usually are. As you can see, like, it doesn't go out much farther than that. So I think that's actually most of the planets. But that's a good haul of oxygen planets. There might still be, like, one around here. Okay, you know what? Closing the window. I don't care how ridiculously hot it is in my room. Fixed. Now, no more freaking goddamn... Well, you might still be able to hear it, but... At least it'll be much dampened. Sound will be dampened. Alright. Yeah, we got a lot of lot of planets around here. Anyway, that's great. So, do we have that colony ship yet? No. Alright, well, at least you're getting a fairly decent number of research compounds, right? How many are you up to? How many does this thing have? This thing is like 10, doesn't it? Or something? Christ. Let me check. What facilities do you have in existence 14? Assuming that I have built 4 here, which is probable. I've built 6 here. Okay. That means there are 8 here. Alright. That's acceptable. But yeah, this is going to be a gigantic research place. Yes, I wish to end my turn. But yeah, this is going good. And come on. Come on, there we go. Temporal technology level 4, alright. 2 research centers completed. Love it. Okay. Okay. No, I don't want move. I do not want to move Alexandria. I want you to warp out there. I'm gonna probably turn on fast ship movement soon. It means that ships will just teleport rather than seeing a flight animation all the way there. I don't know why this produces more research, but probably some homeworld bonus or something. But yeah, population on the planet's growing, that's great. Yeah, we've got more than enough minerals to support it. Even a full research facility. Alright. Now, I'm going to say that there's probably warp point about here and here based on where this is. Because if we look at it like this and then look at the map, and you can see there's 2 little lines going that way, so we're going to move here just to make sure we have all of the planets discovered. Looks good. Alright. Except for like a few places here. That's whatever. Not really too worried about that. Oh, no, no, no. Well, this is... Ugh, I forget how to cancel orders. We're going to backspace, cancel your orders, and move you to that warp point. Oh, yeah. And warp. So send the scout there. That's good. Perfect. Now, what are you building? Are you building anything? We're going to actually go into our ship design now. We're going to upgrade the computerized scout. So it has temporal sensors. Temporal sensors are good because they allow are much more upgraded currently. Basic sensors are meh. I guess as they level up, they're okay, but either way, we're just going to replace this with, and we have computerized Scout Mark II, which we're going to build. Or, no, I want to go here. And end the turn. Ooh, boy. Well, yeah, so far we got a good haul. I really need to start developing ice colonies soon, though. Once I get to, like, level 6 or something, or 7 of temporal tech. Because from there, I should be able to, Alright, so let's see. What's through here? I didn't get to see it, sadly, but oh well. Alright. So, Yeah, that's gonna... Yeah, you know what? Let's just go with level 5. I'm okay with that. Alright, so that's how much it's gonna take for... Okay, so that'll be finished in one turn. But I desperately need to start on ice colonies. Like, I just have so many ice colonies just sitting here. Begging. That's the problem. Alright, so what's the system? Yeah, the Huju system is opaque to most scanners. So, this is a nebulae system. You'll notice that there's a bunch of storms all over the place. It's not even worth it for me to be here. I'd be much better off moving over here and trying to find the warp point. Move to. Yeah, okay. You have some movement left. Move here. Anyway, I'm going to end our first gameplay episode here, with the game date being 24/01, each turn, of course, taking, you know, 1/10 of a year. So, thank you everyone for watching. As always, this has been Kaelvin, signing off.